The Gordon Prize is annually awarded by the National Academy of Engineering, and it's intended to support experiments or new modalities in education that develop leaders in engineering. I wanted to try to create something like biodesign as a way of paying back for the great luck I had in being mentored well early in my career. When I just started as an innovator, I was in the right place in the right time to have experienced mentors help me out with those first steps. So I thought it made some sense to try to develop a more structured, repeatable program, and that led to the fellowship initially in the classes and the rest of the program that became biodesign.
Creating a repeatable, teachable process makes it accessible to a wider range of people to understand, like, you don't have to be Steve Jobs, you don't have to be Bill Gates, you can be yourself and just use common sense and an objective lens to think about, how would I want to make the world a better place?
The idea that one could actually train people on innovation in this space was sort of a novel concept, but it really has resulted in a tremendous wave of enlightenment around this being a reasonable thing to teach students and actually a really beneficial thing to the healthcare system and for patients.
The most essential thing that I learned as a biodesign fellow was taking the time and having the patience to really hone the unmet clinical need and doing that before jumping into any solutions. I think that's the hardest thing to do when you're coming from an engineering background, is having the patience to look at the need first because you're so solution oriented. But I think if you do develop that skill, it's a skill that will be important for your entire career.
We like to think about the need as the DNA of the invention and the company or whatever project that arises. The need really forms the basis of everything that we do. And it can often define the success or failure of a project.
The team-based structure is probably the most critical element to being successful.
We bring people with different disciplines together to look at that problem together and go through the process together.
Cross-disciplinary is really important in health technology. It's always going to involve a lot of different disciplines. Engineering, medicine, computation, physics, all that. And it's part of what makes it so fascinating and interesting, but it's what's necessary to get to the solutions.
We do a good job of training folks in a way that's genuinely interdisciplinary, but also deeply experiential. By that I mean we take very seriously a commitment to give our students and fellows a real-world experience in innovation.
That is how you learn in the field of innovation, by getting your hands dirty, being part of the process, and reading a book or reading a chapter or reading a particular article is important. But being immersed in the experience is the critical element that will make one successful.
We bring experts from across the world in their own specialties to engage with the fellows and students throughout their process at the right times, sort of coordinated.
So I've been lucky enough to be a volunteer mentor at Biodesign to the fellows and the students. And what I've observed through my experience and the other mentors are that the most important thing we can bring is experience. The scar tissue, the learnings, the things we've seen through successes, our network. So when a question of engineering or product design or regulatory or reimbursement comes up, either we or someone we know can help out.
We've been trying to share our training approach and our materials broadly. So we have partner programs in 5 countries outside of the US. These are both developed and developing countries. Our teaching materials, our texts and videos are used by literally hundreds of programs around the globe. Some of our trainees have gone on to start and lead programs in the US and abroad. So we've put a lot of energy and time into trying to share our resources and our approaches, and we were really happy that the committee recognized that. The thing I'm most proud of with Biodesign is the fellows and students who have gone off to productive careers in technology innovation. It's tremendously gratifying to see the impact that they're having. We have already a million patients who can testify to the fact that technologies invented by our fellows and students are coming into real clinical care.
And all of us get involved in something like this because we want to make a difference in the world. And there's no better way to do that than training people.
Biodesign has become the gold standard in medical technology innovation, not just within universities, but also within medical device manufacturers around the world.
Every good team needs a fantastic leader, and that's what Paul is. He is the glue that inspires and holds together all of the dozens or even hundreds of people who contribute to making Stanford Biodesign a success.